Most of the time we are chanting our rounds just to complete our rounds in a mechanical way. And how to reach to the stage where we can chant from heart. Usually we chant by the lips and complete the rounds. I have completed my rounds. So what is the meaning chanting from the heart?
The heart is the seat of our desire. We should desire pure devotional service. We should desire to please Krishna. We should desire prema bhakti. We should desire to please Guru, Vaishnavas and Krishna. We should chant with that desire. If that is our desire when we're chanting, then we are chanting from our heart. The heart is the seat of our spiritual desires. What do you want? Do you want pure devotional service? Or do you want to get your rounds done? If you want to get your rounds done, then just keep chanting and pulling down those counter beads and you'll get your rounds done. Which is good. You're getting your rounds done. There will be, some of those mantras will go deep into your heart. But maybe not so many. But chanting from the heart means I'm chanting because I really want to purify my heart. I see so much lust and envy and anger and pride and greed and illusion and anger. I see all these things. I don't want it. I want to wipe it away. I want to wipe away all these attractions and aversions and attachments and upadis. I see them. I'm sick of them. I'm disgusted with them. They drag me birth after birth after birth after birth away from Krishna. And they're doing it again. Even despite I've received so much, still these material attachments are pulling me away from Krishna. Contaminating my mind. I don't want it anymore. Krishna, save me. I want to be your pure devotee. I want to be an instrument of your love. And in this spirit, we really cry out the holy name. We cry out the holy name to cleanse us, to save us, to save us from Maya, to empower us to become pure. Do you want love of God? Or do you want to just get your rounds done so you can go on to the next thing? If you want love of God, focus on that. And focus on all the impediments that are diverting your attention. And only the name can ultimately save us. But you can't just sit down and do that unless through the day you're really trying to cultivate the attitude of the servant, of the servant, of the servant. If you're offending Vaishnavas, if you're doing prajapa and talking nonsense and all these other things, you're not going to be capable of doing that when you sit down to chant. But if you're trying to live your life in the spirit of achieving that love, and then when you sit down to chant, and you see all the impediments, and you see all the desires, and you see all the conditionings that are so deeply seated in your mind, you want to get rid of them. And you know the only way, there's no other way. I've tried it for years and it just doesn't work. I know, I'm convinced, I've heard it in the books, I've heard it in the classes, I have personal experience of it. The only way is Krishna's mercy. And Krishna's mercy is manifesting in His name. And that mercy is accessible by how humbly and sincerely I chant. That's the
That should be our meditation when we're doing our rounds. I need to cry out for the mercy of the holy name. I don't need to just get my rounds done. I need that too. I need to get my rounds done in this mood. Without the mercy of the holy name, I'm lost. Harinama, 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 Eva Kevalam. In this spirit, we should pray for mercy as we're chanting the holy names, like beggars. If a beggar, as we were saying in Padarsana, if a beggar comes to you with a beautiful silk sari and diamond necklace just coming out of her Bentley, Rolls Royce, or whatever, and says, please give me bakshish. There's not much feeling in her heart. But if a lady who really has nothing and she comes up with you with, she's hungry, she's diseased, she's in rags, and she says, bakshish, bakshish, she means it. Yes. So we have to understand our poverty condition. We've been given so much, but still, so much disease, so much hunger. That's a humble state of mind. That's why Trinada Pisunicha, in such a humble state of mind, like a beggar, we're crying for mercy.